We know that the Figma to Webflow plugin lets you copy and paste Figma designs into Webflow. But what if you could sync designs between Figma and Webflow? With the Figma to Webflow app, not only can you import your Figma components and variables, you can also sync changes from Figma into Webflow, where you can then review and apply those changes directly to your site. This is super helpful if your design system lives in Figma and you want to bring those variables and components and apply them to your Webflow site. And you can make sweeping changes quickly with a press of a button.
Technically, it's more like three.
Three presses of the button?
More like three presses of three different buttons.
That's true. One to sync, one to review, and one to update. And we will cover this in five steps. First, we will show how to set up the Figma to Webflow sync. Then, we will build components from scratch in Figma. We will sync those components from Figma to Webflow. We will make changes to components in Figma and sync those to Webflow. And finally, we will cover how to solve conflicts when syncing components. Emily is here as our client, and we're building her a site with components built in Figma, and I will build and design her site in Webflow.
Honestly, I'm super excited about this.
Likewise. Okay, let's start with setting up the Figma to Webflow sync. And there are two parts. First, the plugin in Figma, then the app in Webflow. In Figma, let's head up to Resources, then Plugins. We would type to search for Figma to Webflow. And once you open it, you can move forward to then connect your Webflow account. In your browser, you can select the whole workspace in your Webflow account, or you can select specific sites within a workspace and then authenticate. Once I've connected the site back over in Figma, in the plugin, we can now click Let's Start. The Copy Paste tab, as we know, lets you copy frames we designed in Figma and then paste those into our site. We actually have a separate lesson on Webflow University that covers this. But we want to make sure we're in the Design System Sync tab. Then, in the dropdown, let's select the site we authenticated moments ago. And now, we can move to the second part, launching the app in Webflow. And this one is pretty quick. Because once we head over to our site, we're in the Webflow Designer. And if we open the Apps panel, as expected, the Figma to Webflow app is already there. And that's because we authenticated this site in the Figma plugin. Let's launch the app. And now, because the plugin is open and we are on the Design System Sync tab, the app will then connect, meaning we successfully created the sync between Figma and Webflow. All right, so now that the plugin and the app are connected, we can move on to the next step. Let's create our main button by starting with some text. I would just use the text tool and type, click here. Next, let's right click and add auto layout. Now, this is important because in order for our designs to work, we need to have auto layout on all our Figma designs before syncing them over to Webflow. Otherwise, the sync won't work. And that's because auto layout in Figma will get converted to the industry standard CSS Flexbox in Webflow. All right, now I have a frame with our text and auto layout applied. Now, let's just resize it so it looks more like a button. For the fill color, Emily, what's your favorite color?
Chartreuse. Wait, no, the color of a banana peel.
I've actually never heard of that. What even is that? Oh. That's your favorite color?
Okay, how about beige?
Let's do something darker.
Yeah, that looks great.
Okay, great. And to make this more scalable, we will save this color as a variable so we can use it throughout our design. Let's name this color/brand and click create variable. So our button color is now set to our brand color variable. And if we deselect everything and head over to our local variables, we can see that the variable we just made is inside a group named color. And the button looks okay, but let's make some adjustments to the text and make it white. And let's also add some border radius to the button, maybe 5 pixels. And we can make a variable out of this too. So same process, let's name it size/border radius, and now create. Now we have a variable, border radius, inside a group called size. So why is all of this important? Well, once you sync, the structure of your variables collection here in Figma will be the same as the structure of those variables in Webflow. So before you add more variables to your design, it's a best practice to organize your variables in Figma now to make it easier to manage both in Figma and Webflow later. Are we done? No. To use the design system sync, our button needs to be a component. So the last thing we're going to do is right-click to create a component. Now it's a component. We can tell because it's purple. And let's be specific and rename it to button. And just to be clear, that component name in Figma will not only become the name of the component in Webflow, it will also become the name of the class in Webflow. So just like with variables, you want to make sure you're labeling your layers and elements descriptively in Figma now for cleaner class names in Webflow later. But that's it. Now we have a component in Figma called button with a color variable called brand and a size variable called border radius. But because design systems often include tons of components and variables, I will create some more while Emily lists her favorite design systems. Emily, you have 5 seconds.
Material.io, Google's design system.
Nice, and I'm done. Now we have a navbar, a card, and that button we just made. And these components are using the color and the border radius variables. If I make a change to the border radius, it changes everywhere that variable is used. That's the beauty of variables. But let's undo them, because we're ready to sync everything here in Figma to our Webflow site. So in our plugin, we want to make sure we're in the select mode. This one only syncs variables, but we're here to sync both components and variables. Let's go back to the select mode. Now, let's select our components on the canvas. We can just click and drag to select all of them. And in the plugin, let's click continue. The plugin recognized that there are 3 components and 6 variables. So now let's sync all of them over to Webflow. And while that's syncing, back in the Webflow Designer, there are currently no variables in our variables panel and no components in the components panel. But not for too long, because in our app, we successfully synced our designs. I can now import those 3 new components. And when I do, the components have been added. And so have our variables. Everything is matched to our designs from Figma. I can now start adding these components to my site and even use the variables throughout my site to keep everything consistent. And just like that, we successfully added those Figma components and even used the variables throughout our site.
Sara, so I actually changed my mind about that color and a few other things.
Well, then it's time to move on to our next step, how to sync changes in Figma so they get updated in Webflow. Emily, what are the changes you want to make?
Just a few, maybe the brand color, change the border radius, modify the card component.
All right, first one, we're back in Figma and over in our variables, let's edit that brand color and change it to...
How about the color of a perfectly warm hot chocolate or razzmatazz? Something good.
Maybe this one.
That's perfect. Love it.
Okay, and again, since we're changing the variable, all of our components using that variable also gets updated. That's why the color changes on both the button and the card. Okay, that's the first one. Next, back in our variables, let's update the border radius to be...
Let's do 50 pixels. Actually, make that 16 pixels.
Got it, done. So the card, what's the change here?
Let's move the image to the top.
All right, how does that look?
Looks great.
Perfect, those are all of Emily's changes. Let's sync. Same way as before, select all the components, make sure we're in the selecting mode, and sync to Webflow. Back in Webflow, in our app, we synced over all our updates, and we can even review and inspect those changes in each of the components. Everything looks good, so now we can just update. And instantly, all of the changes we made in Figma have been applied to our site in Webflow, all at once. The brand color, the border radius, and the cart. So that's syncing changes. But before we move on, there's one critical thing to note. The app and plugin are called Figma to Webflow for a reason. And that's because it's a one-way street. Because Figma is the source of truth for your design, any changes you make in Webflow do not sync back to Figma. So a best practice is to make your styling changes in Figma, not Webflow. This includes changes to names of a component or variable in Webflow. In fact, if you change the name in Webflow, it will unlink that component or variable from the Figma versions, which means if you then sync again, the app will import the Figma version as a new component or variable because it doesn't exist in that Webflow site. Okay, that's everything when syncing changes from Figma to Webflow. Finally, let's talk about dealing with conflicts.
Well, my number one rule is never go to bed angry. Do you mean calendar conflicts? If so, only accept invites with agendas.
That's great advice, but not that type of conflict. What happens in my Webflow site if I delete the element from a component in Figma? Let's check it out. Back in Figma, in our cart component, let's delete the image. Because I've changed the structure of the cart component, when I sync it back to Webflow, we can see that there's a component update with a conflict. So if we click in, look into the cart component, it shows that image is missing from its component. And that's because I deleted it. And there are three options to resolve this. First, I can delete the missing element from the Webflow component. This might be what you want, but be sure, because remember, that means the image will no longer be there on any instance of this cart component throughout the site. Secondly, I could import this cart without the image as an unsynced component. Then we create a separate new cart component in Webflow that is not synced to the cart component in our Figma file, meaning it's only managed in Webflow. And finally, I could just go back to Figma, undo everything, bring back the image, and forget that this whole thing ever happened. For now, I would delete the missing element, and sure enough, that image is no longer on the cart components on our site. But it's not just these instances. If I add another cart component, the image is not there either, because we updated that cart component in Webflow from our Figma file. And that's it. Let's recap, because we covered a lot here. First, we set up the design system sync from Figma to Webflow. Then, in Figma, we built components with variables for color and border radius. Next, we synced our components and variables to Webflow using the app. We made changes in Figma and then synced those changes to Webflow. And finally, we covered how to solve conflicts when syncing components. Now we go into so much more detail about Figma to Webflow over on Webflow University. So check that out if you haven't already. But that's design system sync using Figma to Webflow.
In Figma.
And in Webflow.